Baltimore DPW workers still trying to figure out what to do about a sinkhole that opened up last Friday at a busy intersection in Canton.
That was breaking news Friday on 11 News at 5. And today that sinkhole is causing lots of headaches for people who need to get in and out of the city. 11 News reporter Lowell Meltzer joins us live from DPW headquarters downtown with an update. Lowell, I know that is a major intersection.
It certainly is. Folks going, it's one of the arteries in and out of the city, as a matter of fact, especially for folks heading north on I-95. The reason we're here downtown, though, is that DPW officials just wrapped up a meeting to decide what exactly to do about this issue. And I'm now told instead of taking weeks, it's actually going to take more like days. Taking a look at that intersection from Sky Team 11, that's O'Donnell and Conkling Street, you can see the metal plates that are covering the sinkhole and Jersey barriers there to keep people from driving in that area. At this point, I am told that officials have to clear a sewer drain there to better assess the problem, and then they can figure out how to tackle it. But we did speak to folks out in the neighborhood earlier today, a lot of them frustrated by the traffic woes. It's certainly not the best place for a sinkhole. Just ask folks who own businesses near the intersection of Conkling and O'Donnell Streets in Canton.
We actually have customers that walk in or come in and give us artwork or orders. One of my concerns is whether they're actually going to be able to get here.
Over at PGX Promotions, their business relies on folks coming into their office from downtown and surrounding counties using I-95. With O'Donnell Street closed going west, there are a lot of concerns, especially when it comes to getting deliveries on time.
We typically close between 4 and 5 p.m. Well, you know, depending on how many routes CPS has to do, and if they have to reroute their deliveries, that means they may not get here at all. While we're still here during the day, so we miss our deliveries.
It was last Friday afternoon when DPW crews were informed of the sinkhole. The initial road closure tied up traffic for hours. Now, after inspecting the site, DPW officials say that it could be weeks before it's repaired. That's not great news for folks over at Push 511. The health club's owner says that that could put a strain on some of their clients who have to use I-95. And can get caught at the rail crossing by using the Boston Street detour.
The routes that they have us rerouted to, there are train tracks, and as anyone knows in Canton, when those trains get on those tracks, they're parked there for 20 minutes.
In the meantime, commuters who live and work in that area will have to take things in stride, and it seems, at least for some, it may not be that bad.
I don't foresee it being an issue. The majority of us that work here kind of know our way to manipulate the road a little bit, so I don't think it'll be a huge issue, hopefully.
So again, folks out in that neighborhood of Brewers Hill were originally told that it could take weeks to fix this. We are finding out late-breaking information that it actually could take days rather than weeks. Still, it will be a little bit of a headache, so if you're going to be around that intersection or you usually use it, that's O'Donnell and Conkling Streets, the best thing to do right now is to make other arrangements. We're live downtown tonight. I'm Lowell Meltzer, WBAL-TV 11 News.